Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a quick and easy technique to create powerfully compelling HDR-style photographic portraits from ordinary color photos, and then how to quickly replace your subject with another. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. The first step is to convert your photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as allow us to adjust the effects that we'll be adding to it at any time. Smart objects also allow us to replace our subject with another without having to redo the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. This portrait effect works best when your photo is cropped tightly around your subject's face. If you want to crop your photo, open your rectangular marquee tool and drag it over your subject's face. Go to Image and Crop. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Filter, Other, and High Pass. I'll make the radius 2 pixels, but you may want to adjust this amount between 1 to 4 pixels depending on your document's size and resolution. Your High Pass image should look like this example. Then, click OK. Change its blend mode to overlay. Make a copy of the layer to intensify the effect. Copying the layer actually has a different result than just increasing the original high pass radius. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. I'll make the saturation minus 40, however, feel free to adjust this amount. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Exposure. Exposure increases or decreases the brightness throughout the image, but it affects the shadow areas far less than the highlights. Offset does just the opposite. It darkens or brightens the shadows without affecting the highlights too much. Finally, gamma correction primarily affects the midtones. For exposure, I'll type in 0.5. And for the gamma correction, I'll type in 0.6. However, since each photo has its own characteristics, feel free to adjust these amounts. As I toggle back and forth from the original photo, you can see the difference. Next, I'll show you how to replace your subject with another without having to redo the effects. Double-click on any smart object to open its source image. Open another photo. Press V to open your Move tool and drag the new photo onto the tab of your source image. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize and position it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Click off the eyeball icon next to the original photo to hide the layer and close its tab. When you see this message, just click Yes to save the changes. Then, open your portrait document. Immediately, the smart object updated the effects with your new photo. To resize and/or position it in the document, go to your Layers panel, scroll up to the top smart object, and make it active. Scroll down to the bottom layer and shift-click on it to highlight all the layers that comprise your portrait. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. If you see this message, it's just telling us that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Click OK. To see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Drag it into position and press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!